You all know the notch. That little black cutout at the top of your screen doesn't do much except taking up space. To make it dynamic though, there is an app called Boring Notch, which inherits the dynamic island feature from the iPhones onto the Mac. Just hover your cursor over the notch, a sleek little window pops up with some cool animation. You will see media controls on the left, where you can play, pause, songs, or any sort of media you're listening to. Beside that, there is a tiny calendar, which is a nice addition, but I prefer a different one, which I will talk in a bit. Also, you can see max battery status up top. I mean, all these feel super seamless and very native to the Mac. You can also drag and drop files through the tray, turning it into a trolley while you are moving files around. In short, Boring Notch makes your boring notch way less boring. Hey, by the way, this comment 4 years ago inspired me to make this video, so I'm gonna feature 9 more free Mac apps in this video, so stick around. As a Mac enthusiast, I'm always on the hunt for new Mac apps, but it can get a little bit frustrating and messy when the apps clutter up the menu bar. That's when I discovered Hidden Bar, a truly hidden gem. This lets you hide certain menu bar icons to keep your workspace clean and distraction free. Once you install it, a vertical line appears on the menu bar. Everything to its left stays hidden until you click the arrow button to reveal them. Heads up, you will need to keep holding the command button while trying to move the icons or the line itself. As I said, this is truly hidden gem. It's simple, it's clean, it's perfect. Now, CopyClip. As the name suggests, CopyClip is a no-nonsense, quite simple clipboard manager for your Mac. It does exactly what you need. It stores everything you copy or cut across your Mac, making it really easy to revisit your clippings whenever you need. The app quietly lives on your menu bar, letting you tweak how many clippings it remembers or displays. You can even blacklist certain applications that you do not want CopyClip to track. In my case, I blacklisted iCloud Password Manager to keep certain things private. Just a straightforward way to keep your clippings under control. Speaking of control, Space Launcher. Space Launcher has been my go-to keyboard shortcut app for the Mac. You know, it's the first app I would recommend anyone to download on their new Mac, even myself. Let me show you how it works. Open up the preferences. There you can assign a unique key to a specific application. Then hold down the space bar while pressing the assign key to instantly launch the assigned app, making multitasking a breeze. I've customized my setup to fit my workflow. For example, holding space plus S opens Safari. Space plus M takes me to Mail. Space plus F brings Final Cut Pro. Likewise, all of my frequently used apps are just a keystroke away, saving me a ton of time and clicks. But the best part is it doesn't stop there. Need to open up a particular folder? Easy. Want to directly launch a URL? Done. Basically, dig into the preference and customize according to your liking. I'm pretty sure you will love it. It's simple, it's effective tool, and it's a must-have for anyone trying to up their productivity game. If you're looking to spice up your Mac's desktop with a fresh look, Unsplash Wallpaper is the app that you need. Whether you're looking for something calming, vibrant, artistic, from breathtaking landscapes to minimal designs, there is something for everyone. It offers a vast collection of high-quality, copyright-free wallpapers that make your screen look stunning. One of the best features is its automatic update option. You can set your wallpaper to change hourly, daily, weekly, or even browse through the various themes and handpick the one that fits your vibe. Love a wallpaper? You can directly download it on the spot with just a click of a button. With Unsplash Wallpaper, your desktop will always look fresh, no more boring backgrounds. Now, moving beyond aesthetics, Macs are always known for its efficiency and performance. But there have been days when I'm into my deep workday, juggling between Safari tabs, editing a heavy 4K project in Final Cut, having Photoshop rendered in background, suddenly my Mac starts to crawl and the dreaded spinning beach ball appears. I used to wonder if it's just my Mac or something going on in the background, but then I somehow got to know about Memory Diag, which till day saves my butt. It's designed to monitor and optimize RAM usage in real time. You can see a detailed breakdown of how much app or cache memory is being utilized. Just click the recycle button and within seconds, your system breathes free and feels snappy again. Thanks to Memory Diag, I can keep my Mac in peak shape all day. Now, when you delete any app the usual way, I'm pretty sure that there are high chances of the leftover files or these preferences or any junk file could be still hanging around taking up your valuable space. That's where App Cleaner kicks in. Just drag and drop the app that you want to uninstall. This nifty little tool won't just remove the app, it thoroughly cleans out all of its associated files, preferences, ensuring no traces left behind. It's ideal for anyone who values tidy and an optimized Mac, like me. Moreover, the smart delete feature makes things even easier. Once enabled, you can skip opening the app entirely. Just drag any unwanted app directly to the trash can and the app cleaner will automatically take care of the rest. Honestly, I wish somehow Apple integrates this essential feature into the macOS itself, but until then, App Cleaner is an inevitable tool in anyone's toolkit. Earlier in this video, I promised that I will talk about my preferred calendar app of my choice. It's Itsycal. Itsycal, again, a menu bar app, very lightweight, it's always within my reach, but never in the way. I love how seamlessly it syncs with the built-in calendar app. Now I can just glance my upcoming events right from the menu bar. Clicking on the plus icon lets me directly create an event without having to open the calendar app. Just a couple of clicks and I'm done. Another thing I really appreciate is that how customizable it is. I tweaked the font size to make it easier on my eyes, modified the date format to match my preference, and even set it to display 2 months at a time for a broader view of my schedule. Now I've got date, time, and all my calendar events in one place. It's so convenient and it's such a small change, but it has made a huge difference in how I stay organized and I monitor things. Speaking of monitors, I've been a dual monitor guy as long as I remember. But one thing that has always driven me nuts is manually adjusting the brightness of my external monitors by at their back. Those tiny fiddly buttons hidden at the back are a nightmare to deal with. While scrolling through Reddit one day, I stumbled upon this app called as Monitor Control Lite. And to my surprise, it was exactly what I'd been looking for. This lets me control all my monitors, including external and internal, directly from the menu bar. No extra features, no complex configurations, just the essentials done right. Before wrapping up, I need to tell you about one thing. It's again a menu bar app. It's literally just a text box that displays whatever you put into it. Be it a high priority task or an action item, it always keeps you focused on that one thing, again on the menu bar. So there you have it. These are the 10 free Mac apps that I absolutely cannot live without. Well, it was a clickbait. But there are so many other apps and features that I cannot wait to dive into and explore. I've got plenty more videos in the works and all are on your way. So do subscribe and take care.